Hello again. We're here today to learn how to make a 90 degree cold work elbow. This is the elbow back. It's got a number two swage going around there, nailed together with a rivet there and there. We have its opposing partner, the throat. There's our throat, it's 90 degrees, held together with a rivet there and there with a throat swage on the inside. Now we're going to learn how to make a quarter pattern which does both halves of the elbow. So let's get started. First of all, we need to draw in baseline. So drawing a baseline. Our fitting is going to be 80mm. So we set our dividers up to 40mm, half of the diameter. That. And draw in a semicircle on the baseline. Like this. We're not going to be using a set square, we're just going to use a ruler. So to find 90 degrees, so we know we're 90 degrees, these are dividers just by opening them up. Put a scratch line in there, and the same on this corner, scratch line in. Now, from this point, through the centre will give us a 90 degree angle. So we just draw that in through the centre of there and through the centre of there. And there is 90 degrees. Okay, well, we need to set our dividers back to our diameter. That. Just check it, make sure we're okay. Lovely. And divide up our semicircle to make the quarter pattern. So we have a division there, come down this side here, and a division there, and going up for the height of our fitting, and there we go. We now connect the centre line, the outside edge of our semicircle to the height of the fitting through there, and this half here will make the throat. When we make the throat, the counterpart, the cutout, will make the back. So we need to draw in a baseline down here. We draw in our baseline. Our baseline again, and we need to draw in a horizontal line there to mark the edge of our fitting. Right, so we'll number these 1, 2, 3, and 4. We now need to draw in vertical lines to the line of intersection. So line of intersection here, just draw that in, and the same again with this one. There we go. These divisions here are our radius, and this is our line of intersection. Now we mark out circumference using our circumference lines here. So we set dividers up to that. Just check them to make sure. Okay. As you can see, that's lovely. So now we go in here. That is number one. So this is 2, 3, 4, 3, two, one. So we'll number these. One, two, three, four, three, two, one. We can do this because as we're going around the circumference of the pipe, the visions repeat themselves, so we can do it like this. Now we're drawing our vertical lines. Points. That complete. Now we start to develop our pattern. So we take our dividers and we open them up to the highest point here, to this side. Tighten them up and draw that in. Side. And go to our next point. We draw that in, making sure we're on the outside of the line. Just draw it up. It's in there. Goes in there. And we go to our next point. These dividers were on a pencil in, they won't close up to that. So I've got another set here just to do that last one because it's a small one. We'll just open these up. We're marking them a pattern manually here and here. Now we just three hand draw these in and this will form mounds upon there and the same on this side. Here we go. Now we'll just take a measurement from the bottom and lift it in here, just marking 50mm. Same on this side, 50mm. Just join that across. And that is our throat template complete. We just need to add on some lap. So we're going to add on 1.5. centimeters and the same on the side, 1.5 centimeters. Draw a vertical lining. This is only for our lap, so just draw a vertical line in there. The same on this side, just draw a vertical line in. Through like that, and we run that through like that. Now, if we take a measurement, of the height of the fitting, that's the edge of the fitting there, we took the height of it, there, look, I'll just pull that up there, and the same on this side. We have both halves of our quarter pattern, the back and the throat. All this is left now is to cut it out, and I'll draw it in so you can see the cut lines. So it's straight down here, Is our pattern. We put these through the slip rollers to get them formed into half round. Through the swager on one half, number two, and through the throat swager through here to form the swagers to hold them together. We then just mark in on the lap line here at about an eighth of an inch. Put in the dart, same here, and that is where your holes will go. Alright, thank you very much for watching. Please remember to subscribe to my channel. Until next time, thank you very much. Goodbye.